Hi, welcome to Harmony with Su-Lynn, and in this tutorial, we're going to show you how to use the paint tool to add color. The assets you'll need is a drawing of a character. Here I have my bird of paradise. The first thing you may want to do when you're drawing is to use pen settings to bring up the stabilizer tool. I have it on average, but there's also the option to have pull string. And you could put in the value that you'd like stabilizing. There's also the pen pressure feel and to change the values of that. You may also want to use the close gap tool and also the line build tool. So all these help you with your drawing and make sure that you have the drawing in the line art layer. If you're not seeing all the art layers, you can visit my tutorial on preference settings. You can have your character design on just one drawing layer to begin with, and on the line art layer. You can then choose the select tool and separate out all the different pieces for your character design. We're going to start with the pupil and cut and copy, Command X. We'll make a new drawing, name that pupil. Once we've made the drawing layer, we can make sure we've selected on that layer and then paste the pupil into that. We can use the solo keys to make sure that the pupil is in the right layer. And now return back to the main drawing. You can also use the light table to highlight the layer you're on. Let's continue and select the eye, Command X, which copy and cuts. Make a new drawing, Command R, and name it eye. We can also be specific and put front eye or F_eye for good practice. Paste that into the new front eye drawing. And let's continue going back to the main drawing. This time let's select the beak, Command X, and we can use the shortcut to bring up the drawing, Command R, and name that beak. Now let's paste that in. With the head of my bird, I'm going to select that whole piece, cut that, paste it into a new drawing layer. I can see there's a little gap where I had previously drawn the beak, and we can fix that quite easily. In my previous tutorial on the pencil tool, we covered how to close gaps using Snap to Contour, and then using the contour editor to move the points on top of each other, and that will close your gap. We'll need to do that to add paint and fill it with color. For the body of the bird, we can check if there are any gaps by using K to show stroke. We can see there's a big gap where the neck is, so instead of drawing a line, we can actually use a stroke to close that gap. Close gaps using the contour editor and the snap to contour on. So now you have all your pieces on different drawing layers, we can now go ahead and add color using the paint tool. But first of all, we need to do one more step. Select on the piece that you'd like to add color to and make sure that you are on the line art layer. Go to the tool Make Color Art from Line Art, select that. You can go to your drawing panel just to have a look at your piece. And when I select on the color art layer, I can see the stroke, which is going to let me fill that with color using the paint tool. I can select my color. I have some colors already made. Select the paint tool, just drop in the color. I'm going to do that in the camera view so I can have a look at the whole piece together. Because I have separated out line art and color art, I can now put color on the line art layer. Repeat the process for the front eye. Make sure you're on the line art layer where you've drawn your eye. Select Create Color Art from Line Art. Have a look at that in the drawing panel and you'll see a blue stroke. Select the color you'd like for the eye and then choose the paint tool and drop in the color. I'm going to change my line art layer by selecting it and then choosing the color from my color panel. I'm going to put some highlight and tone on my pupil. Choose a stencil brush. The stencil brush works with existing color. What you can do is to work on top of color and it will stay within the area of that color. Choose the color for high value. Change the size of the brush, or you can hold down O and drag to increase the size and then paint it on and it will stay within the area of the color. I'm going to add some low value, add some tone and a little bit of highlight, increase the brush a little bit for a little sparkle on the pupil. I can repeat the process for the eye. If you add some highlights, for instance here, I've added some highlight on the beak and you changed your mind, it's as simple as just choosing a different color and then dropping in paint on top of that to repaint it. You can also add gradients in the multi-wheel color. You have an option to go with solid or to go with gradient. If you select gradient, then you select on the indicators to choose the color that you want to go from and to. You can change the position using the edit gradient tool. You can also bring different palettes in. Just click on the hamburger menu drop down. You can look at importing different palettes from different projects. You can also import textures. Go to the hamburger menu, color, new texture, and then you can find the texture that you would like to import. I have some I've already imported. So select on the layer that you want to add the texture, drop it in using the paint tool. You can go to edit gradient texture to adjust the positioning of that texture. So this can be repositioned, it can be rotated, and it can be scaled, but just be aware of resolution when you're scaling up. So experiment and explore with your pictures that you can bring in. And that's it for adding color using the paint tool. See you next time.